December 31st, 2015. This is a Maltese poo, 7 years old female.
Not spayed.
Not spayed.
Okay, what is your main complaint? The owner came in because of the blood in the urine?
Yeah, blood in the urine.
Blood in the urine. When was that?
Recently? I think few months back.
Yeah, and then recently?
It's the same one.
You saw it? You saw the blood?
Yeah.
Reddish?
Yeah.
Okay, so I asked the owner.
Huh?
Okay.
It's like a few drops.
Like a few drops of blood after urination.
In between the urine, or after something, most of that is after. Yeah.
After urination, the blood comes
down. Yes,
so,
right.
So she managed to collect directly from the dog. The dog peed, and then this morning, right. So we will take the urine for analysis. There seems to be something inside. Is there something inside?
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. There's something inside tissue or it looks like tissue. You can see.
Mm.
Oh, something inside. So we'll check now. So now what I do is, I will do that physical examination. The medical history is blood in the urine. And then you see that sometimes the dog find it difficult to urinate, right?
Yeah, sometimes.
So it's a dysuria and hematuria, the blood in the urine and difficulty in urination sometimes. But it doesn't drink a lot of water.
Doesn't.
Mm. But does it pee a lot?
Several times, but only when this. The other time when it's okay, then okay. Pee only once a day.
So she pees several times when there is
irritation.
Infection in the bladder. Or otherwise, you will just pee only 3 times a day, right?
Once only.
Once a day. So this is one of the signs of urinary tract infection. And so now, I just want to ask, when's the heat? Because this dog not spayed, when's the heat period, the bleeding? The menses?
Menses is June and October.
So June and October.
April and October.
Uh-huh. April and October. So today is December. So.
But this October, I don't notice much.
You didn't notice.
I don't know whether it's that. Or maybe she
did. Don, you better come here. Or you stand there for what? You come here already. Huh? Come and hold the dog. That's why I'm supposed to do internship and you stand there. You like observer like that. Huh? Okay, so Don also is doing internship. No, he's doing internship. So okay, so I hold the dog.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so now I asked the medical history already. So there's the estrus period. So she says, you're sure it's April and October, so 6 months later, which is true. So now it's 2 months after the heat period.
But this time I don't notice, because she's on this, I don't see her.
She's leaking it off, huh?
I'm not very sure.
Okay, so try and zoom here and then not just fix one view. Okay, so now I start the examination. Now we check the mucous membrane, pink or not? Okay, we check here the gums, quite pink, you can see it's quite normal. The teeth needs a bit scaling, in fact a lot of tartar here. Didn't do any scaling, right?
No.
It's quite common, old dogs don't get. So it's pink, it's normal. Capillary a few times, less than 1 second, then it comes back the colour. Okay, so I go straight to the throat, there's a bit of pain. Then the submandibular lymph nodes. Okay, let's skip on. It's axillary. See any lumps or lymph nodes? There's some pain. Okay, axillary. Inguina. Oh, just behind off. And the dog, is the dog in pain?
No.
No, hot lip tear. I just feel the lymph nodes. Okay, then now I'll do the lung and abdominal. Check the heart first. Any coughing?
No.
No coughing. Vomiting, diarrhea?
No.
Okay, stool. So eating, drinking, urine and stool is normal. Temperature is normal, pulse, respiration normal. So overall is normal. Heart also okay. Heart and lungs normal. I'll check abdomen. Quick check on the abdomen, so that system holds the dog. Okay, normally you hold forward. Now I'm doing here, so you got to
hold it. Going front.
Okay. So that system holds, so I'll check the abdomen, palpation. This one you can feel for any bladder stones or pain or lumps. So I start anterior abdomen. You can see whether the dog arches the back or not. Oh, there's pain, okay. There's pain. And the pain is anterior abdominal pain. This is very unusual. Now I go to mid abdomen. also painful. So this is something is definitely serious here. So normally the dog doesn't feel any pain, so I won't do it anymore. So I go straight to X-ray and test. Okay.
So you touch the pain means what?
Something inside, inflamed or... Otherwise there should be no screaming. Like I'm hold the dog, then the armpit, hold the armpit, that's it. Right. So I turn upside down ready, 1, 2, 3, hold the armpit properly, hold at the joint there. Okay, so now we check below. Mainly check the skin below, and the vulva here. Now you can see that it's very much swollen. See, it's very much swollen, which is not normal. Unless she has a urinary tract infection or infection of the womb, because this dog is not spayed. So as you can see, it should not be swollen. You want to see? It should not be swollen.
Oh.
Hold one first. And so I check whether any discharge or not. If there's discharge, then it confirms pyometra, but there isn't any discharge. No discharge. No, this is the urine.
Okay.
The dog has been taking the private part so often that it becomes swollen.
Mm.
Normally, at the end of heat, it should be smaller. The heat is supposed to be October. But it's swollen. And then you check for forced pregnancy and milk. This has the dog been licking the mammary gland. Oh, there's some milk here.
Sometimes.
Yeah, there's this milk here. You can see. Focus on it. This is at the end of forced pregnancy. So this dog does have... This confirms that the heat period was about 2 months ago. So the milk production has gone off already. So you're just lucky to see a bit here there. Okay, so this dog had forced pregnancy ending already. And this part is swollen. So it's likely either infection of the birth tubes, the called open pyometra, where there's dirty brown thing coming out. Anything? With tissues and all this?
Something like that.
Okay. So one possibly is the infection of the...
It's like jelly-like, small patch.
Of the uterus, or the bladder. Both of them will produce this tissue, which so happen we can see it there. If it comes through the urine or not, because we don't know, because sometimes it's the infected uterus, the pieces drop here into the vagina here, and then when the dog pee, it comes out with revealed tissues. You can see? It's not very obvious, yeah. Okay, so since there's pain here, it's possibly that there's some severe inflammation, either of the womb or of the bladder. So the recommendation is the urine test, set up, and then a bit of blood test if you want to, and the X-ray for the bladder and kidney stones, finish it.